You can watch this video because it is loaded onto your smartphone's RAM as cache memory, similar to any previous short video you've watched. However, it will be deleted once the app is closed. But how does this tech work? How does your smartphone RAM, made of billions of MOSFET transistors, work? Let's take a close-up view of your smartphone's RAM. This is RAM, which consists of billions of FGMOS transistors. Let's dive deep into your smartphone memory and see how does this transistor work. The FGMOS transistors are a type of MOSFET transistor and serve as the building blocks of modern storage devices. For reference, a 16GB RAM memory is made up of billions of these transistors. This is the MOSFET transistor, a switch that can control the flow of electricity with incredible precision. The structure of a MOSFET consists of green regions representing N-type semiconductors and pink regions representing P-type semiconductors. The terminal connected to the substrate or body is known as the substrate or body terminal. The other two terminals are referred to as the source and drain terminals. Between the source and drain terminals, there is a thin layer of insulator or dielectric. And above this insulator is the gate terminal. Since the MOSFET is symmetrical, the source or the drain can be interchanged. Therefore, the source terminal and the substrate terminal are internally connected, resulting in the MOSFET having three visible terminals. This internal connection prevents any current flow between the substrate and the source, since they are at the same potential. In the MOSFET, we want to allow conventional current to flow from the drain to the source. This operating mode is called the cutoff region. To achieve this, we connect a battery between the drain and source, creating a voltage called VDS voltage between the drain and the source. When we observe the graph of the drain current versus VDS, we can see that the positive end of the battery increases the potential at the drain terminal, leading to an expansion of the depletion region between the drain and the substrate. As a result of this expansion, there will be no current flow from the drain to the source, and the MOSFET is turned off. The operating state is referred to as the cutoff region. To allow current to flow from the drain to the source, we need to create a channel between them. This is achieved by applying a small voltage between the gate and the substrate, with a positive terminal connected to the gate. This voltage is called VGS, as it is the voltage between the gate and the source. The substrate of the MOSFET is a P-type semiconductor, which means the charge carriers are holes. However, there are also some free electrons present as minority charge carriers. When a voltage is applied, an electric field is created inside the substrate, causing the electrons to flow towards the gate, but they are blocked from flowing further due to the presence of the insulator. As the gate voltage, VGS is increased, more electrons get attracted towards the gate and start filling some of the holes. Due to the stronger positive charge of the gate, holes start moving away from the gate. This results in a region near the gate becoming negative, or an N-type semiconductor, effectively creating a channel that connects the source and drain internally. This channel allows electrons to move from the source to the drain. By changing the gate voltage, the thickness of the channel can be controlled, and the voltage at which the channel is formed is called the threshold voltage. With the channel now created, current can flow from the drain to the source through the channel. However, it's important to note that the conventional current flows from drain to source, but the actual flow of electrons is in the opposite direction. That is from source to drain. As the drain voltage, VDS, is increased, the depletion region between the drain and substrate also increases, since they become reverse biased. The channel width starts to decrease toward the drain end, due to the negative charges being pulled into the drain, restricting the flow of charges and reducing the current flow. At a certain voltage, known as the pinch-off voltage, the channel is almost completely pinched off. However, due to a large number of electrons in the channel, there is a constant saturated current, and the MOSFET operates in the saturation region. To further increase the current and the MOSFET, the gate voltage can be increased, which increases the width of the channel and, consequently, the current flow. MOSFETs are voltage-controlled devices, because the amount of voltage applied to the gate controls the flow of current from the drain to the source. The two graphs shown in the video represent the drain characteristics and the transfer characteristics. Constant VDS of the MOSFET. MOSFETs are used in modern power supplies, signal amplification, storage devices, integrated circuits, and much more. Let's look into each case with much detail. Modern power supplies utilize MOSFETs as current sensing devices to protect both the power supply and the load. Let us understand the working of the current sensing device. To achieve this, we insert a small valve resistor, known as a sense resistor, into the current path. This sense resistor will experience a voltage drop across it. To measure this voltage drop accurately, we use a MOSFET transistor connected in parallel to the sense resistor. The gate of the MOSFET transistor is used to read the change in voltage across the terminals. In the voltage across the terminals changes, the gate terminal will exhibit a proportional change. By applying Ohm's law, V equals IR, we can observe the information regarding the change in current. MOSFETs are currently used for audio signal amplification. Let's delve into how the amplification works. As we know, the gate of a MOSFET is used to control the flow of current between the source and drain terminals, and their currents are proportional. In audio amplification, the audio signal to be amplified is applied to the gate terminal, causing a current to flow through the MOSFET. As the signal value increases or decreases, the current through the MOSFET also varies, but it is significantly higher than the original signal. Consequently, the signal is amplified. MOSFETs play a crucial role in the fabrication of microprocessors and are currently employed in the production of modern processors by Intel and AMD. FGMOS, or floating gate metal oxide semiconductor, is a specialized version of the MOSFET. It possesses an additional floating gate capable of storing electric charge, enabling it to be used for data storage purposes. For more information on data storage, please refer to the video on the channel. MOSFET are crucial components for the modern world. So, the next time you use your smartphone or power up your computer, remember the MOSFET silently working its magic behind the scenes. That's all for this video. If you have any further questions or tips, feel free to drop us a message in the comments section below. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share this video, and watch the rest of my videos from my YouTube channel. Please also consider to support me on Patreon. Thanks very much. See you on the next video.